But if you want to post anything into IFRS, non-leading ledger, okay, then system will not use this number. System will ask you the separate number for IFRS. And that you have to maintain in the configuration. Let me show you that configuration. So I'll go to SPRO. IMG, financial accounting, financial accounting global settings, documents, number ranges, or maybe document types. You have this defined document types in the ledger. So your ledger is IFRS. Here you have to specify the number range. So your document type is AA. Okay, and which number range you want to use for it. So maybe I'll just go for let's go with 01. I don't know whether that is maintained or not. Let's see. Save it. No, it is not used. So we need to first create the number range. Let me create the number range first. So define the document number ranges. Your company code is SF01. Click on intervals. Okay, although this 01 is available, but it is not picking. I'll tell you the reason. So let me just click on new 99. Let's say for 9999 99901, and let's go with this one. Okay, let's say this, come out. And now go to this document types in a ledger, IF. For document type AA, let's maintain this number in 99. Let's try to save. See, now it is not stopping us. Why? Because for non-leading ledgers, the number range that you are defining must not be already in use by the leading ledger. Okay, 01 is already being used for document type SA, AB, which are used for ledger posting 0L. So we need to create a separate number range which should not be disturbed for 0L, which should be completely different for IFRS. Okay, so now if you again go back to our invoice and let's try to post this. Okay, so now system has posted the document. Okay, let's see how many documents are getting posted. So if I go to document and display, so this is which document? Can you tell me this is operational document or valuation specific document where I can see the vendor? Or if you go to header, you are able to see the document type KR. So this is which document, operational or valuation specific?
Operational.
This is the operational document, right? Then where exactly will you be able to see the valuation specific documents? So in the operational document, vendor is credited and technical clearing account is debited. Now, if I want to see other documents, you have to go for more. Okay. In the environment, here you will be able to see document environment and all the accounting documents. Just click on accounting documents. It will show you how many documents it is showing. It is showing you total of 4 documents, but if you see, accounting documents are 3. This is an asset transaction. This is not a accounting document. There are only 3 accounting documents, 1, 2, and 3. So first one, you can see this one where there is no ledger group, which means this is applicable for all the ledgers. Okay. So this document, which we are seeing currently, operational specific, and these two documents, this one and this one, are valuation specific documents. So if you double click on this 0L, it is showing you technical clearing account credit and asset account debit. Okay. Similarly, if you go to the next one, which is only for IFRS, see, this is the number range which we just now created. So double click, it will also show you the same thing. So in short, one operational document and same number of documents as your depreciation areas not depreciation area, sorry, same number of documents as your accounting principal will be created as valuation specific documents. Okay, any questions? And now if you want to see how this asset will look like, you go to AW01N, which is your Asset Explorer report. Okay, so you can see it is showing for different accounting principles, even parallel currencies also appearing here. So in India GAAP, there are two accounting principles, sorry, there are two depreciation areas. One is your main depreciation area and second is for parallel currency. And for IFRS, you have this depreciation area, which will show you the IFRS results. Okay, so for this particular asset, if you just look at year 2019, we acquired this asset at 10,000. Okay, so the acquisition cost for this asset is 10,000. System, we told the system the life of this asset is how many years? 5 years. Okay, when we created this asset, let me show you what I mean. If you go to this asset master AS03, so when we created the asset, we told the system that for book depreciation, the useful life is 5 years. But for IFRS, the life is 4 years. So what would be the depreciation? Depreciation would be every year, the total value of the asset divided by 5, because in the 5 years, entire value should be depreciated. But in case of IFRS, it will be total value divided by 4. Okay, so let's see whether it is getting calculated properly or not. So 10,000 divided by 5 is 2000, which is correct. So every yearly 2000 would be depreciated in case of leading ledger. But in case of IFRS, if I double click on this, you can see the value is different. But what is happening now, these are getting calculated in real time and this will be getting posted also in real time. But in case of ECC, these values were calculated in real time, but the posting was only happening as a delta depreciation area at the month end when you execute ASKB, periodic transaction. Okay, so that is a benefit of this new asset accounting. Each and every depreciation area is independent of each other. Okay, so if you want to know, this 2500 is for a complete year, but every month how much amount will be depreciated, you can go to posted values and it will show you every month there will be the depreciation of 208.33. so if you sum it all in the 12 months, it will be matching to 2500. But in case of book depreciation, you can see it is only 166, which will be summed to 2000. Okay, any question till now, anything that you not understood? No? Okay, let me add one more scenario here. Now, we purchased the asset. Okay, let me first show you some things and then I'll come to here. So if you go to the master data, now you can see system has automatically determined the start date of the depreciation. And also if you go to the general one, here you will be seeing the capitalization date. So this will come automatically when you acquire the asset. Okay, now what was the price at which we purchased this asset for 0L, which is our India GAAP, and for IF, which is our IFRS reporting. So what are the price at which we purchased this asset? What is the price?
10,000.
10,000.
10,000, right? So this was also 10,000. This was also 10,000. So in this case, okay. But let's say now consider a scenario. Cost of asset is 10,000 plus there is a freight of 1,000. So what do you think? What should be the cost of asset? Whether it should be 10,000 or it should be 11,000. What do you think? It should be 10,000 or 11,000 including freight.
It will be depending on the accounting principle of that country.
Exactly. Let's say it will be totally, there is no firm answer that whether the value will be 10,000 or 11,000. So if you see the rules, each country has different rules. So we are just taking the example. Let's say India GAAP says 10,000 because freight is not the part of the asset. But let's say IFRS says, no, this is, even freight is part of the asset. So you have to book this as 11,000. So in that case, what you will do? Because whenever we are purchasing the asset in the asset acquisition, we are not specifying separate price for each accounting principle. We are just specifying 10,000. And for both the accounting principles, it is taking us 10,000. Now let's say, for example, after posting this transaction, I want to correct it. So as of now, this is incorrect. This is only 10,000, but I want 11,000. So can I post one additional 1,000 only for IFRS? Is it possible in SAP ECC to post depreciation area specific posting? You only want to post 1,000 to IFRS. It should not affect at all to your leading ledger. Is it possible? Have you understood my question? I'm repeating again. In SAP ECC, if I want to post something only to a particular depreciation area, not to all the depreciation areas, is it possible? What do you think? Yes, no, maybe something, at least you answer. Something on the chat screen.
Yes.
Yes, possible. Akash, is it possible?
Yes.
How can you do? Can you just tell me? How is it possible? How can I, which transaction code should I use? Akash, can you tell me which transaction I should use to post only in IFRS? Or the way, forget about the transaction code, like how is it possible? How can I proceed with that transaction? Akash, you don't remember or what exactly? If you remember, just tell me so that I can correlate that scenario. Okay, let's say Akash is right. Akash is correct. Okay, it is possible. But I only want to understand how. Maybe someone else can answer this. It is possible. 100% it is possible, but there is a way. So which is that way? Sorry, Ujay?
Transaction type specific.
Transaction type specific. Yes, transaction type specific. So in SAP ECC also this is possible. If I want to post only,
and I think we can do by F-90 we can enter this amount.
No, if you do with F-90, okay, let me show you. Okay, that's the reason I'm telling you, make this interesting, then you will be able to benefit it. If I just keep on telling, it will not make sense. Okay, so yes, so you are saying I use transaction F-90. Okay, I'll specify the vendor, If I press enter, 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 and all, so reference. Okay, so now the question is, if I specify 703002 and if I specify the transaction type as 100, then it will go to all the ledgers. It will not only go to IFRS, but we want to post only to IFRS. If you want to post only to IFRS, it is only possible if you create a particular transaction type. Okay, if you create a transaction type and in that transaction type settings, you say that this transaction type is only valid for this depreciation area. Okay, so there is a configuration in SAP ECC where you can create your own transaction types and you can restrict a particular transaction type to the particular depreciation area. So let me show you. I don't know whether it still exists or not because it is not required anymore. But let's see if it is available. So in asset accounting, you have these transactions. And let me go to general valuation, depreciation areas. No. Okay, acquisitions, define transaction types for acquisition. No, not here, but there is one place in SAP ECC where we specify that this transaction type is only valid for a particular depreciation area so that system will post only to that depreciation area. Okay, but in SAP S/4HANA, we don't need that. Okay, so transaction type specific depreciation areas are not supported anymore in S/4HANA because SAP has provided a new transaction code which will automatically allow you in the simpler way. So normally for asset related transaction, we use this transaction called as AB01. If you click on, if you go for AB01, you can post different kind of transactions on the asset accounting. AB01 is a common transaction in ECC also. But again, whether this transaction will be posted to all the ledgers or to the particular ledger, it depends upon the transaction type. Okay, again, we are not going to use this. The new transaction is AB01L. AB01L. Now you specify your company code, your asset, forget about the transaction type, or you can specify transaction type 100. Press enter. Okay, see here it is asking you for which accounting principle you are posting this. So I want to post only to IFRS. Okay, this transaction AB01L is not available in ECC at all, and that is the reason we are dependent on transaction type. Okay, here we are using the same transaction type 100, but we are specifically, these fields are included now in AB01L. Okay, so the document date is 01/04/2019, again 01/04/2019. Asset value date is mandatory, so 01/04/2019. Amount posted, I want to post 1000. Okay, just click on enter. Let's go to more. Okay, now definitely we need to provide the corresponding GL account, right? Because we are not going to charge vendor for this. Vendor will be only charged for 1000 because freight is related to the different vendor. So it should go to the clearing account. So system will ask us the clearing account. Let's see. Let's try to post this or simulate this. So it is asking you contra account for acquisition value. So we have to provide a contra account for the acquisition value. So first create the contra account. Let's go to FS00. Contra account can be balance sheet account. So I'm just creating 203. Balance sheet contract for asset purchase. Okay, and then go to control data. Again, I think it is required to be asset. Let's see. G007. Let's click on save. I doubt, I think it is not required. So let's remove this and we'll see if it is required, we will make it save. Okay, and then you will go to transaction AO90, where you specify the GL accounts. So let me go to transaction AO90. Our chart of depreciation is SF01. In the account determination, we need to go for vehicles. And this is available in the balance sheet. And we are specific to IFRS. So this is the contra account. So we need to provide 203, which means this 202 will be debited and 203 will be credited. Just click on save. Okay. Now if I go to this transaction once again, let's try to simulate. Okay, so it is working fine. So 202 is debit and 203, which is a contra account, is credit. Okay, and this will be only for IFRS. This is not for different accounting principles. This is only for IFRS posting. So if you click on post, okay, so asset transaction was posted with this document number. And now this is only document number, right? It will not go to zero at all. So there is no question of operational document and valuation specific document, because we are using transaction AB01L, which itself means we are only posting to the particular valuation area. So this document is only valuation specific. Okay. Now if you go to Asset Explorer, double click on book depreciation area. So here 10,000, but in IFRS, let me just refresh this asset. You can see it is 11,000 because freight is also part of this. And you can see very clearly that there are two transactions, one for 10,000, second for 1,000. Okay, so accordingly system has also changed the depreciation, because now it is not anymore 10,000 divided by 4, it is 11,000 divided by 4. Okay, any questions till now?
Gaurav, Sandeep here.
Yes, Sandeep.
So Gaurav, in real time, so how this situation or how this scenario is handled? So will they post this amount, total 11,000 amount at a time, or separately they will post 1,000 for another accounting principle?
Yes, so at the same time 11,000 is not possible, Sandeep, and that is the reason we are using AB01L, because at the same time you are posting the transaction to multiple majors. Okay, and normally once the document is posted, okay Sandeep, so it is not possible in the single transaction that we have the two separate values for two depreciation areas. So whenever you are purchasing, first of all, both will have the same values, and then you can post the adjustment entry.
But for the accounting principle India GAAP, right? So we need to book total 11,000 at a time, right? So in this case, so operational document will be like when we are posting first time. So that time account operational document will be created for 11,000 only, right?
Yeah, if the requirement is 11,000 for both India GAAP as well as IFRS, then you will be posting 11,000.
Okay. Otherwise, we will just go with the 10,000. Then additionally, for the 1,000, we will separately post two documents for each accounting principal.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. Okay, Gaurav, thanks.
Okay, so let's now try to proceed with this scenario. So normally what we do, once we purchase the asset, we go for the depreciation run, right? So if you go for the depreciation run, again, we first need to configure the GL accounts. Okay, so maybe before I go to transaction AFAB, let's go and create some GL accounts which can be configured in the account determination. Okay, so the first thing that we need to create is we need to create a GL for depreciation, which is an expense account, and we need to create a accumulated depreciation, which is a part of the balance sheet account. So I'll go for 204 new. So GL account type would be balance sheet, and this would be my accumulated depreciation account for vehicles. Okay, so control data, this would be reconciliation account type for assets. And here you need to specify G0067 once again. Okay, so just click on save. And the next GL that we need to create is for expense. So let me see which range is available for expense. So we only created one expense, 400. So I can use 401 new. This would be primary or secondary. Depreciation is what? Primary or non-operating? Depreciation cost goes to CO or not? Normally we want to post, right? And that is the reason I'm creating this as a primary cost, right? And this is a depreciation account for vehicles. Okay, let's go to control data. Nothing is required here. Go to create bank interest in the field status group. Let's select the expense account. Okay, so cost accounts are G004. Again, just click on save. Yeah, this is important. The cost element category was not specified. Do you want to lock the GL account for posting? I'll say no. See, if you are not creating the cost element for the primary cost GL account, that GL account will by default get locked till the time you don't create a cost element. Okay, so just say no and specify the cost element here in the control data. Okay, so cost element category would be 01 and save this. Okay, now these two GL accounts that we created, again we need to go to transaction AO90, and in the depreciation tab we have to specify the depreciation accounts. So accumulated depreciation account here, which is 204. Okay, so what are this, sorry, let's first assign this expense account, which is our depreciation account, which is we just now created as 201. Okay, sorry, 401, not 201, 401. So this is our accumulated depreciation and this is our depreciation. Okay, what are these accounts? So you must be aware in SAP ECC also, depreciation are different types. You have special depreciation, you have unplanned depreciation, you have transfer of reserves. Okay, so we are only providing the ordinary depreciation. Ordinary depreciation means the depreciation that we carry out every month end. Just click on save. One more thing, if you remember in SAP ECC, if you want to post your depreciation also to the cost center or any other cost object, then there is one configuration, which is in financial accounting, asset accounting, integration with general ledger accounting. There is something called as additional account assignment objects, where you need to assign the objects which are required at the time of asset posting. So specify account assignment types. Just click here. Select your company code. Go to depreciation area. So book depreciation area, account assignment object. Just click on new entries. Here it will show you all the different account assignment objects like fund center, grant, profit center, segment. But currently we are going to use cost center. We have specified the cost center in the asset master, right? So just click on cost center. Here normally we provide star. Okay, so this should be star and this should be APC value. One more line for depreciation. So again, KOSTL. This should be star and this should be depreciation run, and this too has to be ticked. Okay, this is common. Even in ECC also you find this. So I think it is star, it is not ticking. Let me put manually star. So this by default star is not working. You have to specify star. Okay, so just click on save. Now we have done this for depreciation area one. For other depreciation areas, is it required? Do you think IFRS and parallel currency it is required? Normally not required. Why? Because CO postings are only going to ledger 01. So it will only go to the book depreciation, not to the IFRS. So anyways, cost center postings will not go to IFRS. Okay, so you can skip this activity. For this one, it is mandatory. Okay, so now if I go to transaction AFAB, which is our normal depreciation posting, this transaction also has a new look. Okay, so if you go to AFAB, you can see there are a lot of changes compared to ECC. In ECC, you are specifying whether you are performing the repeat run or you are, there were different options, right? Whether you are performing the special depreciation, unplanned depreciation, whether you are rerunning, you are repeating. Okay, so all those options are not available because in ECC we are telling the system what to do, but now SAP S/4HANA system is intelligent enough, it automatically collects the information whether this is a normal run. If you specify the special depreciation, it will automatically consider the special run. If you already executed the depreciation for particular selection criteria, it will all automatically consider as a repeat run. Okay, so you don't need to provide those information. Also, this accounting principle earlier, because without accounting principle 01, it was not possible to execute the depreciation. So it was always considering 01 and then it was passing on the values to the other depreciation areas. But now, even you can perform this depreciation run for a particular depreciation area independently. Okay, which is normally not required. Normally, this is a month-end activity which is done on the same day for both IFRS as well as local accounting principle. So normally we don't provide this, but there is an option where you can provide this information also. Okay, so specify the posting period as one, and then totals log will give you the total log. It will not tell you asset by asset. If you want asset by asset, in ECC there was a tick mark, list assets. Okay, so if you want to do that, click on detailed log. Okay, all other things are same. If you want to specify the asset, you can specify the single asset. Otherwise, just click on execute. This is the test run. So execute. It is saying there is a document number range 03 missing. So let's create the number range through FPN1. SF01 interval 03 is already there. Then why it is saying it is missing? Depreciation posting run, create document number range using internal. It is set as external currently. Okay, so let me remove this and click on save. Okay, let's go back to depreciation posting once again. Click on execute. normal, even in ECC also you get this message, just click on yes. So for leading ledger, no issue. Okay, it is green, so everything is okay. But for IFRS, it is showing some error. What is that error? Account, okay, we again missed the account. Okay, in AO90, we need to specify the account for IFRS also. So AO90, SF01, account determination for 31,000. Depreciation, we need to go for IFRS and we need to
provide. Here we can assign same ledger, sir.
Sorry, Akash?
Here we can assign same ledger.
Same GL accounts, yes. If you are using ledger based approach, normally we assign the same GL accounts. And I will also tell you one more thing, in which you don't need to provide this manually. There is one configuration in the depreciation area. When we create a depreciation area, system will automatically pick the account determination from 01. I'll show you. Okay, so this is 401 and click on save. Okay, so now if I come out and try once again, let's click on execute. Yes. Still there is an error. Let's see what is this error now. No document number found for entry view of document AF and ledger IF. Now I think you should be able to understand this. So system is trying to create a valuation specific document for IFRS and there is no number range assigned for AF. If you remember, we already provided the number range for AA document type, but we need to now provide for AF. So how to do that? Let's go to the configuration. SPRO, financial accounting global settings, document type, and here we need to provide for ledger IF. Okay, so AA99 is provided, but let's create for AF also. Now if you want to create a separate number range, you can create, but as of now I'm just providing the same number range. So the numbers will be common. Okay, and let's go to posting run once again. Let's come out and execute. Okay, so everything looks fine now. This is green. Okay, so you can see cost center is only flowing to leading depreciation area because only postings from FI ledger 0L are going to CO. If you want, you can also set up IFRS posting going to CO, but this is mandatory. So your main ledger, leading ledger should always post to the CO. Well, this is optional. So if I want to perform this production run, I can remove the test run, but if I execute similar to ECC, it will give me the message that it has to be executed in the background processing. Okay, so just click on continue, go to more, program, execute in background. Just provide the output device. So same, you just need to provide the output device. Enter immediate, or if you want to schedule, you can provide the time. Just click on save. Okay, and now if you want to see whether this is posted or not, you can just go to Asset Explorer, which is AW01N. Okay, so here, if you go for book depreciation, just click on posted values. You can see for the first month values are posted. Other months are planned because we already executed the depreciation for the first month. Okay. I think we discussed a lot of things today. Maybe we should not proceed because at least we need to have two sessions on asset accounting rather than completing everything in one. So let's meet tomorrow again and we will complete this asset cycle. Okay, so we will proceed with the other things like retirement, scrapping, how to deal with that. Although there are not much of changes, but yes, there are small changes in that also. And I'll see if there is anything else in the asset accounting, we will discuss it tomorrow. So any questions? Yes. So my recommendation would be, please go through this video before tomorrow's session because there were a lot of topics we discussed. So if you go through the video, you may come up with a lot of questions again. Okay, so that can be discussed tomorrow. If you have any question now, you can ask. Otherwise, tomorrow also you can ask the questions related to today's session. Okay, I'll try to share this video by tomorrow morning itself so that tomorrow you get full time to see this video. Ujay is asking. Yes. Yeah, just 1 minute. Ujay is asking the question, in account-based approach, suppose we have two accounting principles. Now do we have to create two technical clearing accounts? The answer is no. Technical clearing account will be always one because the value at the end of the day in the technical clearing account is going to be zero. And on top of that, whenever you are using account-based approach, there will be one more account which will be required. Okay, so anyways, Ujay, tomorrow we are going to talk about how to handle account-based approach scenario in SAP.